The president just tweeted this. He said the Philadelphia Eagles football team was invited to the White House. Unfortunately, only a small number of players decided to come, and we canceled the event. Staying in the locker room for the playing of our national anthem is as disrespectful to our country as kneeling. Sorry. So here's the thing. None of the Philadelphia Eagles players stayed in the locker room. None of them took a knee for the season. So what he's talking about, that is in fact a lie as well. So,
well, there's no one more disrespectful to this country than the President of the United States, which is a sad thing to say, but it's true.
You say that it's tough to say that before what you said about you said it's embarrassing. He didn't want to be embarrassed. Don't you think it's tough to say the words that you just said, but you have to because they're true. It's true.
Well, first of all, I'm glad he disinvited us or disinvited the team because we won't have any lingering issues coming into next season, which I think is very important. Didn't want some players to show up and others not to and have it enter into the locker room and you know, keep us back from repeating as Super Bowl champions. So I don't really care what he does. Guy talks about being patriotic. He avoided the draft 5 times. In Vietnam. And Philadelphia is a city that has 2 high schools. One is Thomas Edison High School that lost 64 members of their class in Vietnam, and the other is Father Judge High School that lost 27 members of their class in Vietnam. If he wanted to be patriotic, he could have been patriotic back then as opposed to this sham of an issue relative to the national anthem. Mm-hmm. There, I stand for the national anthem and cover my heart because I am a privileged white male. And I have a reason to stand. There are other people in this country who have not experienced the same level of fairness and same level of issues that I have. And they have a right to show their displeasure. And that's what the First Amendment's all about. And if he doesn't want to accept the First Amendment or other amendments, that's on him. But I'm proud of our players. They're extremely they're wonderful athletes, and they're great in the community. They volunteer. They raise money. They're all of them. I mean, Malcolm and Nathan and Chris Long and Carson Wentz. They all are contributing to the community. So I'm very happy that they're Super Bowl champions. That they're our players, and they don't have to go to the White House.
Okay. So I was asking you. This is the question I wanted to ask you. You said some tough words. Your first answer here. And you released a statement just as tough, saying disinviting them from the White House only proves that our president is not a true patriot, but a fragile egomaniac obsessed with crowd size and afraid of the embarrassment of throwing a party to which no one wants to attend. Tell me about that.
Well, the truth hurts. I mean, and that's the case. It's been happening since he was sworn in, and every day is a new adventure in dysfunction. And I hope we can recover from it. And I'm looking forward to when he's not there to get our country back to where it should be. And that could be 2018, 19, could be 2020. Hopefully it won't be 2024. But it's just an embarrassment. And I'm proud of our Eagles, and I'm proud that they're not going.